Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Here I've got the Steam Deck. It's the cheapest model, which I got for £349. It comes with only 64 gig of internal MMC drive. Let's have a look here on the menu system. As you can see, there's only 43 gigabyte free. So there's hardly any space, and I've not installed anything on this drive. It's pretty much stock. I'm going to upgrade it to the Samsung, I think it's the 991A drive. This is 256 gigabyte. I got this for £17. There's a few things I need. Screwdriver, Phillips, pretty basic stuff. Prying tool, this is optional. I've got the mobile prying set here if I need it. A USB-C drive. You can use USB-A, but you need an adapter, a C2A adapter. Okay, let's begin. First things first, we have to shut it down. Right, before I work on the Steam Deck, I'm going to get the recovery image on this website here. Just type this into Google. Then click on this and go to this website here. And then you'll see the link for the recovery image. For me, it's the Windows link here. Click it and download it. I agree to that. Right, next up I'm going to use an image writing tool called Rufus. I'll get the portable version here. Click on that. Right, in Rufus, load up the recovery image. There's no need to extract it. Rufus can read the BZ2 files. Now it's time to write the image. It's going to take a while, so I'll basically cut to the end. The USB stick's finished writing. Now it's time to open it up. Once the Steam Deck's powered down, we need to first make sure there's no SD card in there, here in the SD card slot, because it can snap if you try to open it up. We're going to need to undo these 8 screws. Basically, these 4 are small screws, 1, 2, 3, 4, and these ones at the end are longer screws, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, let's get to it. Once the screws have been removed, let's open it up. I'm going to use this one. I'm going to start at the top here. definitely better if you start at the top. We're in. Okay, now the back has been removed. Here's my shield production number. As you can see, I don't know if you can make it out, but basically it says 2022 9th 2, so that's September 2nd, and that's how it looks like. Now the next thing I have to do is remove the shield. There's 3 screws holding it, 1, 2. There's one underneath there as well. Okay, let's get removing the shield. Okay, let's undo this aluminium foil here. As you can see, it was already partly torn off. This is still using the same Phillips screw head, I've not changed it. These are even smaller screws, so keep them separate as well. Once the shield has been removed, it's a good idea to unplug the battery, which is done by moving this. Once the battery is disconnected, just trying to power it on to discharge any power in the capacitors. Next is to remove the old SSD. Gently just pry it out. The old SSD comes in a protective shield. Just pull it out like that. There's the old one. Now I've got the new one here. There's a new drive. Simply slot it in at an angle and then push it down with your finger. Reuse the old screw. Okay, once the new drive is installed, it's time to reconnect the battery and put the shield back on. Careful of these heat spreaders. Right, now the screws are back in, now it's time to put on the back case. Let's do the central screws. It's always a good idea to do cross threads. Okay, now it's back together. Let's plug in our USB stick. Now what you have to do is hold on the minus button and then press the power button until you hear the click, and then release the minus button. Right, once the menu comes up, you want to select Reimage Steam Deck. It will come up with this warning. Just click on Proceed. Let me turn off the lights so you can see better. Thank you. Once it's finished, it says. Proceed to reboot the Steam Deck. Right guys, it appears to be done. I'm going to skip all this and I'll enter all my details in now. Right, here we are, we're done. The operating systems have been reinstalled. Let's have a look at the amount of free space we have with this new SSD drive. There you go. 222 GB free. Some of that is being used by the operating system. One minor issue I did have is once it had reinstalled, it got stuck on the starting Steam Deck update download screen. It happened a couple of times. If this happens to you, just press the on-screen B icon for back. It's a bug, and then it will resume normally after that. Okay, that wraps up this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Cheers, and I'll see you in the next video on up to review the Steam Deck properly. Thanks.